Hi, and welcome to this Pinnacle Studio tutorial. 3 and 4 point editing is a great time-saving technique to help you get your edits together quickly and easily. You can use 3 and 4 point editing during any project, but if you've got a lot of video clips to build into a finished edit, or if you need to trim video clips to match the timing of a piece of audio or narration, 3 and 4 point editing can get the job done quickly and with great precision. Points refers to the in-point and out-point markers that you add to the source clip and the timeline. In most cases, you will likely use 3-point editing because it lets you edit precisely without adjusting the speed of clips. 4-point editing, in most cases, results in adjusting the speed of the clip so that it precisely fits a defined time in the timeline. So let's have a look at it in action. I'm creating an edit of a family beach holiday. To give myself the correct on-screen shortcuts, I'll first select 3 and 4-point edit mode from the drop-down here. And I'll need to have the source monitor panel displaying for the clip I'll be auditioning for the timeline. I have one clip already on the timeline, of these two young ladies laughing together. And for this project, I know I want the first clip to start 10 seconds into the finished edit. But I want to add a good scene-setting clip to the start of the project to give the video some context. I can look in my project bin for a wide shot of a beach, and there's a couple of great options here. I'll choose this first one, and the clip now displays on the source monitor. But we can see it's 30 seconds long and we only need 10 seconds. If we go back to our timeline, we can mark in and out points for the gap we want to fill. So we'll go to the start of the timeline and click the mark in flag, or I could press I for in on the keyboard. Then I'll go to the point where the existing clip starts at 10 seconds and set the mark out flag, or press O on the keyboard. Next, I go to the source monitor and scrub through the clip to see where I want the clip to start on my timeline. I want it just where the wave is coming in at about 12 seconds. Then I'll set the mark in on the source monitor, or I can press I again, now that the source monitor is the active panel. If I decide I want a slightly different endpoint, I can just click the mark in flag again to reset it, scrub to a new time location, and press I again. So now I've set 3 edit points in total, in and out on the timeline, and in on the source monitor. I can then either drag the clip to the timeline from the source monitor, or from the project bin, or press the Keep Speed icon. Any of these will add the clip between the in and out markers on the timeline, starting from the in marker on the source monitor. Similarly, if I want the source clip to end at a certain point, but I'm not concerned where it starts, I can set an out marker instead of an in marker on the source monitor. Let's undo adding the clip, reset the in marker, and then set an out marker at about 20 seconds into the clip. When I add the clip to the timeline, the clip will backfill to the start of the timeline. The head and tail frames, the in and or out markers that we add in the source monitor, will be saved with the clip, so that if we want to use the clip again in another project, or maybe at another point within the same project, the in and out markers will be retained to help speed things up for us later. We can of course remove these at any time by clicking the in or out flags again to reset each of them, or just click the clear flags icon. We can, of course, add clips using 3-point editing, where 2 of the points come from the source monitor and just 1 from the timeline. For example, let's say after our original clip on the timeline, I want to add this clip of the campfire and the guy playing guitar, but I only want it to last for, say, 5 seconds. I can set the in marker on the timeline. Then I want the best 5 seconds of the clip, where the guy puts his arm around the girl. I'll set the in marker on the source monitor at about 2 seconds. And the out marker at about 7 seconds. Then add the clip to the timeline by dragging it or pressing the Keep Speed icon. So in this instance, we set 3 edit points again, but this time 2 were on the source clip and only 1 on the timeline. Let's say I change my mind though and I want another 5-second clip between these 2 clips. Let's move the clip we just added so it starts 5 seconds later on the timeline, and we now have a gap to fill. Here we can use either 3-point or 4-point editing to fill the gap. I'm going to add the water slide clip First, I'll set the endpoint on the timeline at the end of the clip of the two girls laughing. Then I'll set an endpoint at about 6 seconds and an out point at about 12 seconds. Obviously, this is a clip length of 6 seconds and our gap is only 5 seconds. So let's see how Pinnacle Studio handles this when we drag the clip to the timeline. To resolve the difference in time, the Fit Clip window appears with a couple of different options. We can either trim the source clip so that it automatically adjusts the source clip to 5 seconds in length to fill the gap. Or we can choose to overwrite the following clip in the timeline. Or we can use 4-point editing in this case. This will actually squash the 6 seconds we've selected into the 5 seconds that are available on the timeline, speeding up our new clip by approximately 20%, so it takes up less time but still honors the in and out markers that we set in the source monitor. We can do this in a couple of ways, either by keeping the 3 markers we have already set and then click Fit to Duration. The clip is inserted onto the timeline with the markers observed, and we can see that the clip has been sped up, as the broken yellow line towards the top of the clip shows that the clip has had its speed altered. Or we can actually set 4 edit points, an in and out marker on each of both the source monitor and the timeline. As we already have an in and out set on the source and an in marker on the timeline, let's just add an out marker on the timeline so that we have 4 edit points. Now, when we drag the clip to the timeline, the Fit Clip window appears again, this time with more options, as it's more ambiguous how we want Pinnacle to organize our new clip. We can choose to align the source in marker with the timeline in marker by trimming the source clip, i.e. moving the source out marker to fit the space. Or overwrite the existing timeline. Or we could choose to align the source out with the timeline out by trimming the source clip, i.e. moving the source in marker to fit the space. Or we could overwrite the existing timeline. Once the clip is on the timeline, we have a few options to adjust the clip between these hidden head and tail frames using the following tools located just above the timeline. Slip, slide, roll, and stretch. Slip lets us drag the clip on the timeline to change which frames we see, the content, without affecting the window or duration of the clip. Essentially, moving the in and out markers for the clip whilst keeping the clip location on the timeline the same. The preview panel will show the new first and last frames, the head and tail frames, of the clip on the timeline as we do this. Slide lets us move the clip forwards and backwards within the timeline, whilst retaining the existing head and tail frames. If you slide the clip over another clip, the second clip will have its duration shortened, whilst also retaining its own head frames. Roll lets us adjust the edit points between two clips by dragging the edge of a selected clip, whilst retaining the first clip's starting position and head frame, and the second clip's ending position and tail frame. Stretch lets us adjust the size of the clip on the timeline, not by changing the head or tail frames, but by speeding up or slowing down the clip to fill the new length of the clip. By hovering over the edge of a clip, the clip boundary will turn green, and we can drag the clip to its new boundary. The clip will show that its speed has been adjusted by the dotted yellow line towards the top of the clip. Hopefully, you now have a great idea of how to speed up your edits and create great videos even more quickly and easily. Only with Pinnacle Studio.